Good evening, guys. My name is Dhruv Shah, and I secured AIR 11 in CMAT MBA CET 2020. And today's topic is 2 months preparation to CET. How you guys should prepare. So, like starting in the first, I'll distribute this in two parts: January and February. And we keep March just for we can consider Feb and March together as one unit. Okay. So let's start with January. I hope that you guys might be knowing which sections are weak, or you might have an idea about how much you're scoring. There might be some students who are scoring only 80 to 90 as of now, or there are some students who are scoring only they are not able to score much in quants, but they are able to score more in verbal or some other section. So let's start with quants first. Now, if there's anyone out here who's facing problems with quants, this is for them, these people. Now, in the month of January, I would suggest you, I would suggest you guys to solve more sectional tests. So, if you want to improve your quant section, you can practice from the CET King Black Book. If you want, if you feel that there are any chapters like time and work, time and distance, these type of questions come along. So, if you are thinking that I want to improve this chapter, then you can solve from the books, or you can solve from a sectional test. And yeah, I would suggest that don't leave anything as of now thinking that your section is weak, quant section is weak, I'll do only few chapters. Still, there's a lot of time considering the exact 2 months, I guess, like 13 March might be a CET date, I'm not sure. The second week of March it happens usually. So there's still 2 months, and you can easily make the weak section as a strong section. So for quant section or quants, I would suggest that just think when you're giving mocks, you might have given mocks. So just analyze that, are you facing problem with time or if the concept? So if the problem is with time, then I would suggest you guys to go with sectional test. And you should give a sectional test for 2 to 3 chapters every day. So if possible, if there's a combined sectional test, as in like 3-4 chapters, algebra ka ek saath mein, or something like that, probability ka 2-3 chapter, probability and permutation combination mix. If you have, guys, I'll be answering your questions towards the end. So please don't post it in the chat box. Just listen to me as of now. So if you have any the combination of 2 chapters or 3 chapters, aisa kuch ya, probability, permutation, so for example. So you should go with those type of sums because you'll get a hang of solving it with the time limit. And if at all you're facing problem with the concepts, then I would suggest you to go to books, solve 5 to 10 numericals of the chapters which you are facing problem. And there might be there might be 3 to 4 chapters, or there might be 10 chapters also. Don't worry, 10 chapters hua to bhi theek hai, 20 chapters hua to bhi theek hai, entire quant is also being then also it is not a problem. What you should do is pick up 5 chapters every day and solve 10 sums from each chapter. So that makes 50 sums. So you make it a point that you are solving around 50 sums every day from the quant section. Every day means you can pick up like 3 days, same chapter, like 150 sums from these, if you consider 30, 30, 30, 30. So 30 sums from each chapter. So that will be good enough for your practice. Then you can move on to the next set of 5 chapters. Aisa you can increase the number, increase your practice in quant. So I would suggest that you should, if there are students who are facing problems with more than 5 to 6 chapters, you guys should go with this and practice this for 15 days, till 20th January or something like that. And then go ahead with a sectional test for the same set of chapters. So there might be less number of sectional tests, but give it diligently and don't mess with them. Because what happens is, if you are performing not taking a sectional test seriously, then you guys might face problem in mocks, and mocks mein score nahi aayega. So I would suggest ki tum quants ko thoda quants jiska weak hai usko tum aise improve karo. And yeah, apart from this, you make it a habit that you are learning the calculations, calculation as in the fractions from 1 to 11, then the 1 to 11, then tables from 1 to 40, then squares and cubes. Squares and cubes, this is must till the last day of CET. तुम्हें जब भी सीईटी रहेगा उसके एक दिन पहले भी तुम्हें यही चीज करना है रेगुलरली फॉर 2 आवर्स. तो डोंट स्किप इट एनी लाइक इवन इवन फॉर अ सिंगल डे डोंट स्किप दिस बिकॉज इफ यू आर नॉट गुड एट कैलकुलेशंस देन यू विल फेस प्रॉब्लम व्हाइल सॉल्विंग क्वांट एंड तुम्हारा क्वांट होगा नहीं फटफट. तुम्हें क्वांट में सॉल्व करने के लिए ज्यादा टाइम लगेगा एंड देयर आर आई नो अ फ्यू पीपल हु आर स्टिल स्ट्रगलिंग विद क्वांट. Like they are facing a for a simple sum also they are taking 3 minutes or 2 minutes just because they are not good with calculation. So I would suggest ye calculation improve karne ke liye this is a good technique. If people are strong with Vedic maths then you guys can follow that page also on YouTube and learn those tricks. So this is about calculations for quants in this month of January. I would suggest you guys to go with सॉल्विंग बिकॉज यू स्टिल हैव टाइम तो सॉल्विंग कर सकते हो तुम ज़्यादा लाइक 50 सम्स एवरी डे विल टेक यू अराउंड विल टेक अराउंड 2 आवर्स और समथिंग. एंड या मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट दोज 50 सम्स शुड बी टाइम्ड. ऐसा नहीं होना चाहिए कि यू आर यूजिंग योर मोबाइल एंड देन यू आर सॉल्विंग दोज 50 सम्स. दोज 50 सम्स शुड बी लाइक 1 मिनट और 2 मिनट्स पर क्वेश्चन इफ यू आर स्लो राइट नाउ जस्ट टू इम्प्रूव योर स्पीड एंड ग्रेजुअली यू surely improve but yeah for starting you can give 2 minutes for one sum so that makes you around 100 minutes 100 to 120 minutes mein tumhara wo ho jana chahiye quants ka sums. So this would be for quants and if you want if you feel ki quants mein I'm not serious towards like I am not give solving it properly then what you can do is go with sectional tests only. Sectional tests zyada karke do ya fir tum passive marks de do. So एक-एक सेक्शन तुम एनालाइज करो अभी लाइक व्हेनेवर यू गिवन मॉक्स मेक इट अ पॉइंट दैट यू नो आउट ऑफ दोस 4 सेक्शन तुम्हारा कितना परसेंटेज स्ट्रांग है कितना वीक है हर एक सेक्शन में. सो व्हेन आई स्टार्टेड गिविंग मॉक्स आई न्यू दैट माय क्वांट सेक्शन इज 60% स्ट्रांग. सो आई हैड टू इम्प्रूव ओनली 40% ऑफ दैट एंड आई न्यू विच वेयर आई हैड टू इम्प्रूव. सो इट वेंट ईजी फॉर मी टू प्रैक्टिस अकॉर्डिंगली. सो फॉर यू गाइज ऑल्सो आई एम टेलिंग यू इफ यू नो where you are weak then prepare accordingly. ऐसा कर सकते हो. Then another thing is sectional test. तो मैंने बोला तुम जब sectional test को भी analyze करोगे just see how they solve the sum. There are several cases where तुमने long method use किया but actually the sum could have been solved using the options itself. तो जस्ट सी दैट मतलब तुम्हें ऐसा नहीं देखना कि तुम्हें सम आ रहा है या चैप्टर आ रहा है कि नहीं. द वे यू आर सॉल्विंग इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट बिकॉज तुम लॉन्ग कट यूज कर रहे हो बट शॉर्टकट में वो सम हो रहा है. सो यू गेट टू नो द शॉर्टकट फॉर द सेम लाइक फॉर सेम टाइप ऑफ सम. सो दैट इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. अपार्ट फ्रॉम दैट एनालाइज योर सेक्शनल स्कोर्स ऑल्सो. आर दे इम्प्रूविंग इफ यू आर गिविंग सेक्शनल टेस्ट डेली or are they remaining stagnant or if they are remaining stagnant it means that you are not practicing much and even if you are practicing then you are using a long method or there is a problem with the calculation. So I would suggest if you guys most of you if you are facing if your quant score is around 18 to 25 so go with a sectional test because that might be a scene for that might be a scenario where you are not good with time management. And if your score is in the range of 10 to 15 or something like that, that means you are not sure with there you are lacking 2 things. One is your calculation and another is conceptual questions. You are not good with concepts and you are not taking your quant section seriously. So this was regarding quants in the month of January. Then with abstract. Yeah, abstract where you need a lot of practice if your score is around 9 to 10. But if your score is in the range of 15 to 20, I would suggest that solve 10 sums every day, 10 to 15 sums every day. And give one sectional test after every 3 to 4 days. That would suffice. Because abstract mein kaisa hai ki you get, once you get to know the idea, then it is, then you knew. Then it's not necessary ki time mein ho because idea aane ke baad you can easily solve the sum within like around 50 seconds or something like that. So I would suggest just a minute sorry I would suggest that you go with solving more in as far as abstract is concerned every day 10 to 15 sums and within 15 minutes it should be done. So the more type of sums you solve, the more categories you get to know, and the more patterns you get to know. Like concept type ka pattern aata hai. There might be 9, then circular aata hai, then mirror aega, mirror and combination of mirror and water image. Then there's a combination of mirror image, like moving patterns, symbols moving in clockwise direction.
Hello. बोल दिया गया है हेलो हेलो टॉपर
गाइस प्लीज म्यूट योरसेल्फ आई हैव ऑलरेडी म्यूटेड ऑल बट स्टिल प्लीज डोंट डू दैट या सो एब्स्ट्रैक्ट सॉल्व करना एब्स्ट्रैक्ट वैसे ही सॉल्व करो 10 टू 10 सम्स एवरी डे एंड यू शुड बी गुड विद एब्स्ट्रैक्ट बिकॉज़ एब्स्ट्रैक्ट मींस Yeah, it's okay. Whatever mistakes have been done, that's okay. Just concentrate on the lecture. So yeah, abstract mein solving would is surely improve your score, and you'll get to know more type of you. Zyada variety you'll be solving, so you'll be getting to know how actually the sums appear in the CET as well. Then yeah, for verbal, I would suggest read everything. Like for 1 hour, you should read regularly. That may be a newspaper or a novel, something like that. Or it might be the in short, you can refer to in shorts also, whichever article you like, you can go ahead and start reading those articles. So that would be a strategy for verbal, because verbal mein, and give sectional test. Yeah, verbal mein, you guys have nothing to as such refer to for syllabus as such. Kuch rehta nahi hai. Matlab sentence correction ka kuch syllabus nahi hai. So बुक्स से सीटी की बुक से सॉल्व करो एंड गिव सेक्शनल टेस्ट एवरी टू डेज एंड सेक्शनल टेस्ट ऐसा होना चाहिए कि तुम्हारा जो स्ट्रॉन्ग सेक्शन है उसको छोड़ के तुम्हारा जो वीक है उस पर ज़्यादा फोकस करो यहाँ पे दिस इज द टाइम वेर यू कैन एक्चुअली स्विच फ्रॉम लाइक कॉन्सेंट्रेट ऑन योर वीक सेक्शन स्ट्रॉन्ग है तो वो तो रहेगा ही स्ट्रॉन्ग को स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट बनाने से अच्छा वीक को थोड़ा ऊपर लेके आके मॉडरेट में करो सब सेक्शंस को साथ में लेके चलो दैट वुड बी मच मोर बेनिफिशियल टू यू So that is one thing, and yeah. So verbal may go with reading every day for 1 hour, and if you have some flashcards, then refer to but those flashcards, 5 to 10 flashcards and one flashcard and 5 to 10 word meanings from that. Just note them down and revise every weekend. So that depends upon your like stamina. If you are strong if you have still have energy after your mocks then revise it otherwise you can revise every day like every 2 to 3 days if you want this is for verbal yeah moving on to logic most of the people might face a problem regarding critical reasoning or puzzles ke saath so and yeah and those normal alphanumeric series that would come with practice and you can give mocks sectional test for that But for critical reasoning, I would suggest कि तुम every day 5 to 10 questions solve करो and solve मतलब ऐसा नहीं कि तुम्हें right answer आ गया तो you skip. I would prefer कि तुम्हें right answer आया तो why that answer is wrong or on the contrary why those 4 answers are wrong because of which you mark the right answer. तुम्हारा thought process क्या था? And analyze your thought process and understand the solution. ये दोनों कॉम्बिनेशन में करोगे तो तुम्हें समझेगा कि एक्चुअल में व्हेन द क्वेश्चन कम्स हाउ यू हैव टू रिफर टू द ऑप्शंस समटाइम्स इट सो हैपेंस दैट स्टूडेंट्स गेट कंफ्यूज बिटवीन इन्फरेंस एंड कंक्लूजन और कंक्लूजन की जगह पे इन्फरेंस मार्क करके आते हैं दैट इज बिकॉज दे आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द पैराग्राफ और दे आर नॉट लाइक पेइंग अटेंशन टू द क्वेश्चन प्रॉपरली एंड इवन इफ दे आर पेइंग दे आर नॉट एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द ऑप्शंस सो तुम्हें आई वुड सजेस्ट दैट तुम लोग क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग के लिए ऐसे सॉल्व करो सेक्शनल टेस्ट तो ठीक है बट सेक्शनल टेस्ट में भी तुम्हें अगर स्कोर नहीं आ रहा है तो तुम ऐसे करो कि तुम सेक्शनल टेस्ट में जो भी सेक्शनल टेस्ट दिया है अब तक उसके सारे क्वेश्चन को रिफर करो एंड सॉल्व इट वंस अगेन बट सॉल्व इट वंस अगेन आई मीन जस्ट लुक एट द क्वेश्चन एंड सी व्हाट आर दोज ऑप्शंस कैसे ऑप्शन आ रहे हैं तुमने उस टाइम पे भी क्या गलती की थी और एक्चुअल में अभी तुम इम्प्रूव हो रहे हो क्या It is important to see, notice that you are notice as in tumhara improvement hai ki nahin. If you guys are not improving, then it's either problem with the seriousness of your studies or it's like you are not working on your mistakes. See, even if you practice 1,000 sums, but you're committing the same mistakes every time, it doesn't matter. It doesn't make a difference. तुम प्रैक्टिस करके रह जाओगे तुम्हें स्कोर ही नहीं आएगा. दिस इज अ वे टू इम्प्रूव योर स्कोर. सो दिस वॉज दिस इज वॉट आई हैड डन इन द मंथ ऑफ जनवरी इटसेल्फ. क्रिटिकल रीजनिंग मेरा बहुत वीक था. एक्यूरेसी वॉज अराउंड 40%. तो 10 में से 4 आता था वो भी बाई लक था. तो वॉट आई डिड इज बाई डूइंग दिस ओनली रीड द क्वेश्चन द पास्ट क्वेश्चन विच आर ऑलरेडी गिवन द टेस्ट में एंड द मॉक्स विच वर देयर. If I got a right answer, still I analyze the all answer, like all the like the entire sum, maybe and then the options. So if you read the options correctly, you'll get to know what is the problem. तुमने assumption और inference तुम्हें लगेगा कि हाँ confused हो रहा अभी भी वो अभी भी इन्हें यही गलती कर रहा. So go slow with that type of sums. Even if it is a mock, go slow with that type of sums. See, it is okay if you score thoda less in mocks. Starting ke 2-3 mocks is okay, but improve your mistakes in those mocks. If you improve your mistakes in the mocks, you will surely get more marks in the like in the coming mocks. So mocks ke marks ke piche mat jao abhi se. Abhi se it is not your final decision. Abhi tumhe 70 bhi aa raha hai to bhi theek hai. But tum 70 ke baad aise 70 ki jagah pe tum 75 aa rahe next time, 5 mark ka improvement is good. But if you are like working on your mistakes, like 10-15 mistakes तुमने work की एक ही mock में, so that is very helpful. तो critical reasoning में तुम्हारा ये बहुत होगा, तुम्हें समझेगा ही नहीं कि तुम्हारा right answer क्यों है, गलत answer भी तुम्हें समझ जाएगा कि हाँ मैं ये एक दो तो eliminate कर पा रहा हूँ, but बाकी out of those 3 how to mark the right answer. So it's okay, you might not get it. तो तुम options को study करो and then go to the passage. So yeah, guys, don't disturb this. If you're not paying attention, then you can mute yourself or please maintain discipline. Yeah. So CET critical reasoning ka you can see or you can go with the options and then go to the actual question. So aise switch karke dekho ki tumhe samjhega ki tumhe अभी समझ में आ रहा है क्या. इट वॉज इट समटाइम्स इट इज ऑल्सो दैट 20-30% ऑफ द टाइम इट इज लाइक यू आर नॉट अंडरस्टैंडिंग द पैसेज. तो पैसेज समझ में नहीं आ रहा है तो इसकी वजह से तुम राइट आंसर मार्क नहीं कर पा रहे हो. तो पैसेज समझना अगर प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है तो दैट मीन्स यू आर वीक इन रीडिंग. अगर तुम रीडिंग में वीक हो तो स्टार्ट रीडिंग फॉर मोर देन 1 आवर, लाइक 1-2 आवर्स. सो दिस वुड इम्प्रूव योर रीडिंग स्पीड एज वेल एंड कॉम्प्रिहेंडिंग कैपेसिटी ऑल्सो. ऐसा होता था मेरे साथ कि स्टार्टिंग में मेरा रीडिंग कैपेसिटी कम था, रीडिंग स्पीड स्लो था एंड आई वाज नॉट गुड एट रीडिंग आल्सो. सो व्हाट यूज्ड टू हैपन वाज आई यूज्ड टू रीड दोस 4 लाइंस बट आई यूज्ड टू रिमेंबर ओनली द लास्ट 2 लाइंस. तुम लोग के साथ भी होता रहेगा आई एम प्रीटी श्योर. तो तुम ऐसा करने के लिए तुम्हें ज्यादा रीडिंग करना पड़ेगा एंड लाइक यू रीड अ पेज एंड देन राइट डाउन अ समरी एंड जस्ट सी इफ यू एक्चुअली कॉम्प्रिहेंडेड इट प्रॉपरली और नॉट. क्योंकि अगर तुम समरी को ठीक से नहीं लिख पा रहे हो that there's 2 chances. You are not be able to writing this, you're not able to write the summary, or you are not able to recall what was there in the passage. So these two will improve only if you start reading more. Reading se hi aayega critical reasoning, because you'll be able to actually analyze the situation which is given in the passage itself. So वैसे improve कर सकते हो critical reasoning in this month. That's read more and go to your previous mocks or sectional tests. Solve those questions once again. Just go with the options. Read why those options were wrong. Then study your like what was your decision behind marking the right marking a particular answer. Then go with the right answer. तुम study करो उसको. You'll get to know what was the actual problem. If reading is the problem, then you will have to read more only. Because critical reasoning के लिए कोई shortcut as such नहीं. If you want to go in the right direction, like by actually solving the set of sums, then the last part is puzzles. Puzzles में तुम्हें अगर ऐसा लग रहा है कि तुम्हारा एक भी puzzle बन नहीं रहा है और CET में puzzles difficult आ रहा है, so that is because you do not have sufficient practice for puzzles. I would suggest कि तुम पहले puzzles को ज़्यादा practice करो. Practice मतलब time लेके solve करो अभी. You can take around 10 minutes also for puzzles right now. Because tum agar abhi zyada puzzle solve karegi, you get to know the variety of questions are being asked. There might be like linear arrangement, matrix combination aata hai. So if you are well acquainted with the variety, then you'll be able to solve much faster as and when your practice starts increasing. So I'm saying ki starting mein solve every day. What I used to do is pick up 5 puzzles from CET King books or from the mocks itself, the previous mocks which I had already given, or from the mock test mein agar mujhe wo right aaya hai, so I used to ignore that, and jo wrong aaya hai I used to solve it again. So usse tumhe lagega ki to you are able, like you are not able to solve 50% of the puzzle, or you are not able to solve the entire puzzle itself. Out of those 8 puzzles which are there, you are able to solve only 2. So baki ka 6 mein, is it because of you are not able to understand the questions, or is it because of the time pressure? So most of the time it is puzzles mein yahi hota hai ki time pressure ki wajah se you are not able to solve. So time pressure agar tumhare paas hai, तो तुम एक काम करो, टाइम की तुम सेक्शनल टेस्ट दो खाली लॉजिक के पजल्स का खाली सेक्शनल टेस्ट दो. तो सेक्शनल टेस्ट में आल्सो यू हैव ऑप्शंस, लीनियर अरेंजमेंट सेक्शनल टेस्ट, देन सर्कुलर अरेंजमेंट सेक्शनल टेस्ट, स्टार्ट विद दैट, देन स्लोली ग्रेजुअली मूव ऑन टू ओनली सेक्शनल, लाइक सेक्शनल टेस्ट, लॉजिक सेक्शनल टेस्ट, पजल्स सेक्शनल टेस्ट. तो लाइक एज एंड व्हेन यू स्टार्ट मूविंग, लाइक स्टार्ट फॉलोइंग दीज स्टेप्स, यू विल सी योर इंप्रूवमेंट ग्रेजुअली. तुम थोड़ा पजल्स का स्पीड फास्ट हो जाएगा, या फिर तुम पजल्स को समझना बराबर समझने लगोगे. तो इफ दिस हैपेंस, इट इज एन एडवांटेज दैट यू आर एबल टू सेव 30-40 सेकंड्स इन योर पेपर एग्जाम. सो व्हाट, तुम फटफट सॉल्व कर पाओगे, या फिर तुम्हें पजल्स का हैंग आएगा. पजल सॉल्व करने में प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, मतलब तुम्हें 30 मिनट्स दिया तो तुम श्योरली पजल को सॉल्व कर दोगे, 20 मिनट्स दिया तो भी कर पाओगे, बट वो 6-8 मिनट्स में वो पजल कैसे क्रैक करना है वो खाली प्रैक्टिस पे आएगा, क्योंकि तुम्हें समझेगा कि कैसे पजल्स में फॉलो करने स्टेप्स. सो दिस वाज ऑल अबाउट जनवरी.